Hello everyone, this is Akang Suman here. Now we are going to solve the questions based on the Hartnell governor. Okay. So in the question, what is given? In a Hartnell governor, the mass of each ball is 4 kilogram. So here I am writing that what is given in the question, that is mass of each ball, that is 4 kilogram. Okay. And the maximum and the minimum centrifugal forces on the ball are 1800 newton and 100 newton respectively. So F1 is equal to 1800 newton and F2 is 100 newton. With the corresponding radius R1 is equal to 25 centimeter. You can convert it into meter. Okay. But here you can see in the options, there is a centimeter units. Okay. So you need not to convert it into meter. And the R2 corresponding to F2 is 20 centimeter. The length of the vertical and the horizontal arms of the bell crank levers are the same. You can see when you draw that Hartnell governor, there will be two arms. One is ball arm and the other is sleeve arm, like that. Okay. And there is a sleeve which is attached to the sleeve arm, like that. And there is a compression spring. Okay. So this is basically A and this is basically B, and in the question it is given that the length of vertical and the horizontal arms of bell crank lever are the same. That means A is equal to B is given. Are you getting my point? So if A is equal to B is given, what formula we have to use to find out the spring stiffness? We all know in the Hartnell governor there are two formulas which is very important, and when you use those two formulas, that is F1 multiply A is equal to FS1 plus MG by 2 multiply B, and the other formula is F2 multiply A is equal to FS2 plus MG by 2 multiply B. When you subtract these two equations, this is one equation and this is second equation. When you subtract these two equations, you will get F2 minus F1 into A, that's equal to FS2 minus FS1 upon 2 multiply B. Okay, MG will be cancelled out. So here in the question it is given that A is equal to B, that means these two will be cancelled out. Okay, and what is FS2 and FS1? We all know that FS is nothing but the spring force. Okay, so if I want to write the FS2 minus FS1, so we will get this is equal to K X2 minus X1, because spring is only one spring is there, so the spring constant is same. X2 minus X1. What is X2 minus X1? I told you many times that X2 minus X1 is nothing but the sleeve movement. How much compression is there in the spring, that will be equal to, that is depend on the sleeve movement. Okay, that is equal to BR2 minus R1 upon A. Okay, this is BR2 minus R1 upon A, and here we all know that A is equal to B, so that is R2 minus R1. Sleeve movement we will get here, that is X2 minus X1. We will get 25 minus 20, that is equal to 5 centimeter. Okay, so now we are having the values of X2 minus X1. And we just have to put this FS2 minus FS1 within this equation. So I'm just writing here new equations is F2 minus F1 is what? If this is equation number third, so here equation number third, from equation number third, F2 minus F1, which is given in the question, okay, this is here, I'm just considering that. Because F1 is greater than F2, so you can write it as F1 minus F2, okay? F1 minus F2, because F1 is greater than F2, okay? So here I'm writing that F1 minus F2, that is FS1 minus FS2, okay? So this is FS1 minus FS2, or you can consider, this F2 and this F1, okay? You can consider this R2 and you can consider this R1, because bigger minus smaller. Okay, we have to subtract like that. So now 1800 minus 100 is equal to k multiply 5 upon 2. Okay, so when you solve this, you will get the value of a spring constant. This is a spring constant. The k value that you will get 680 newton per centimeter. Unit must be same. Okay, unit must be accurate. So here option D would be the correct answer according to the question. Okay, now you are able to understand. If in the Hartnell governor, if there is a question on the Hartnell governor, you must remember these two equations. At least you must remember these two equations. If you remember all the equations that is required, that is if you remember this directly, the time will be saved in the examinations. Okay, but at least these two equations you must remember in order to solve the problems based on the Hartnell governor. Everything is depend on these two equations. And one more thing, this equation is also you must remember. Okay, and the other thing, you all know that slew movement is br2 minus r1 upon a. We have seen in the diagram. Okay, so I hope you will understand the solution of that question.